Hey everybody, it's Bill. How's it going? Part five on this little part. How many parts does it take to make a radiator cover? Probably remember this. Been working on it a little bit. We got it cut, trimmed, laid out, got the beams laid out and ready to go. And I've been telling you that I'm a little concerned about the thickness because it's only 20 thou thick mild aluminum. And you know, it's funny, sometimes when you're talking with somebody about cars and stuff and they say, hey, I did this one time, for whatever reason, an idea popped into my mind. So I was talking to Robert at Vino Rat Rod Builds today, having a fun conversation. We were talking about cars and stuff like that. And he started telling me about his console. And I don't know what it was about that story, but he was telling me about his console. You've probably seen it. If you haven't, go to Vino Rat Rod's Builds and check it out. It's a red console. He got it from a place that he worked at legally. And he just was telling me about how he made it fit and this and that. And we talked about a bunch of other stuff. But when he was telling me that, for some reason, this thing popped into my mind. And I thought, I got an idea. I'm still going to planish it. I'm still going to do the beads, but I'm concerned about the strength, right? So my plan is, I don't know if you can see this in the light or not, but I traced the part out on this piece of aluminum, same material that the other half is made of. And what I'm going to do is cut it out, make it fit relatively tight, snug between the flanges, and then I'm going to take it to the bead roller and put an offset here so that I will create a gap space between the what's going to be the inner and the outer. I'm going to put some reinforcement beads along the part to give it some rigidity underneath the outer, and then what I'm going to do is put the two together. And I'm going to hem the outer, the part you'll see, around this inner piece, and it will have more rigidity. The thing I'm going to do to make sure it has good rigidity, I'm sure you've probably seen this product before, window and door foam. It's expandable. So what I will do is I will get everything together, and I'm gonna fill it with this expandable foam. It's the kind of stuff you use around windows when you maybe replace a window or something like that, or just somewhere where you want to keep, you know, there maybe wind gets through a window or something like that. It's just really good and simple, easy stuff to use. That's what I've always used it for, and I thought, hey, I'll put this between the two panels. They'll both be beaded. They'll both have some rigidity, but with the two sheets, the inner and the outer, with this foam filler between them, I think we'll have something that will be plenty strong and stand the test of time. So that's what I'm doing. Right now, I'm just going to cut the piece out and see how it fits, do what I have to do to make it fit the way I want it to. And the next part will probably be putting the offsets in on the bead roller, the offset flanges, and then running the beads. Don't let me forget to make the die to form the Chevy bow tie in the outer before I put these together. That would be very disappointing. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, that took about 5 minutes. So what I've done is, ouch, I just stuck my finger on a burr. Cut this piece out. Right now, it's just a flat piece. It lays in here real nice, okay? Lays in there real nice. And what I'm gonna do is get a little closer to the camera here. Hopefully you'll be able to see it. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to draw a line here that's longer, further away than this flange, because the flange will ultimately be rolled over onto that flange. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to offset the flange down, okay? And what that'll do, I'll do it here, here, and down here. And what that'll do is it'll create a pocket between the two parts. Okay, does that make sense? So then there'll be air between here, right? Between these two parts. We'll just have a mating surface around the very edges. And what that'll allow me to do then is I'm gonna have the beads pointing down. So I'll take that in consideration too. I'll have the beads pointing down in this part. And then I'll probably have the beads pointing towards the top. I've just gotta make sure that I don't create an interference, because when everything's said and done, I'm going to place these two together and I'm going to hem these flanges over we'll be almost ready to call it a day at that time. One of these days here soon, I've gotta make that, I call it a three-piece die. It's what we call them, you know, in the auto industry. And basically a three-piece die will be used to form the Chevy bow tie in this piece. So the piece will sit like this in the car, okay, like this. And what a three-piece die is I will create a block on the bottom. I'm just gonna make it out of wood. It'd be nice to make them out of steel, but that's expensive. So I'm gonna take and make basically a flat block, and I will put the bow tie emblem, I'll lay it out in there, and I'll clean it out. You know, I'll use a Dremel or whatever I'll use, you know, to clean it out, and maybe put a coat of Bondo in the bottom just so it's a nice smooth surface. And then I'll duplicate that on the, what I will call the punch. So you'll have two pieces of material. The bottom will have the cavity with the Chevy emblem in it, and the top will just be flat, and it'll clamp this metal, okay, the parent metal here, it'll clamp this between those two boards, and then the punch will come through, and the punch will simply press down in that pocket. And what it'll do is, since this metal is all contained and it's being held in place, it'll allow me to put some stretch in the form, and that'll hold the form nice, and it'll add a little bit more rigidity to the piece as well. So that's it for right now. Maybe tomorrow I'll get a little bit more time out here, but you know what, it's Valentine's Day, I'm going inside. I'll see you guys later.